Hello everyone, I'm going to be doing another walkthrough of Black and White 2, except this time I'm going to be talking through it and explaining some of my strategies. But for right now, I'm kind of having a mouse problem. It's not really responding the way I want it to. When I barely move my mouse, like I'm moving it down right now very slowly, but you can see the cursor's not moving. Hopefully it doesn't do that in the game. But we'll see. If it does, I don't think I'll be able to do this very well. I got a new mouse. It's the Razer Naga. So that might have something to do with it.
This is the beginning. The birth of a god. Called by one pure prayer. Born out of desperation. To be a god. To wield the power of good and evil. That is your destiny.
We're your conscience. We're part of you. Our role is to help you be the god you want to be.
So, we'll guide you as you make your godly way through whatever this world throws at you.
But before then, you'll want to learn the basics.
We'll help you with all that, but even more importantly, you'll need a creature. Hey, let's go and choose one.
There they are. Wonderful, aren't they? You have four to choose from. But the one you choose will be with you throughout your whole time in this world. So consider carefully and make your choice wisely.
Let us tell you about these amazing beasts.
All creatures can be trained to become lovable, mischievous pets.
Or they can be the ultimate disciplined weapons of destruction and war. Any creature you choose can become these things.
That's the wonder of a god's creature. It can become whatever you wish. All creatures will grow up to be huge and powerful. They can be cute, quirky pets, inquisitive and fun-loving.
Or they could be single-minded war machines.
All creatures will be as good or evil as you teach them to be.
I'd rather they spread love in the form of a massacre or two by going into battle. Creatures can live for war, domination, and destruction.
Oh, such a shame if you ask me. Whichever creature you choose will change according to what he learns and does.
They all have their own lives, but you need to be a responsible parent and not overfeed them.
So, now it's time to choose. Click on a creature with the action button to highlight him.
I'm gonna be going with my wolf. And it seems my mouse is good.
He's gonna go for the lion. Oh, I know it.
Whoa, it's really sensitive though. Oh, let me change that. A little bit more. Oh. It seems just in the menus that it doesn't really respond, but in the game it's fine. Alright. Let's go with my wolf.
If you're sure, click the action button again on him. Oh, great choice, boss. So, boss, you've been asleep a long time. Do you need the refresher about how to move like a god?
Use the action button on this scroll to find out how to move and look around.
Click the action button on this scroll to skip tutorials.
You'll miss out on tribute if you skip it, though.
Skip it. Just because I know how to play.
This is a gold scroll. These lead you through the story.
Silver scrolls lead to quests in the world.
Bronze scrolls are tutorials, which can teach you so much.
Okay. Oh, gotta get into a black and white mode, because I've been playing Diablo 3 for the past few weeks. Okay. Let's go straight to the game.
Are you sure you wish to leave the land?
Click again to confirm. Oh yeah, hey, they didn't expect that! Split one, villager!
Now you've had a taste of your powers, we're ready to visit our mighty Greek capital.
Yeah, full of people that worship us!
Please hear us! Please
Listen,
help us!
Can you hear
we
that?
Pray.
That's a pure prayer.
Hear our prayer.
It sounds like something terrible has happened.
Mighty One, please heed our call in this hour of need. Our armies are crushed. What's left of us hides in this city from the brutal Aztecs. And now they are at our walls. I implore you, please help us.
Oh my! It's a huge Aztec army! They're invading!
Our city is under siege. The Aztecs have killed nearly all our troops. We're all going to die.
Aztec warriors have scaled the...
You've got a villager before.
Yes, you put him down in the right place. Trapped by the burning buildings. Grab them and drop them in the portal. That villager is now safe. Well done.
What's happening? What's that rumble?
That creature seems to be performing some strange ritual.
Wow, why was that so loud?
As many villagers as we can, and get out of here!
That wasn't my fault, so sorry if it killed your ears. Just does that sometimes, I guess.
What are these crazed Aztecs doing? They crushed our villagers with barrels!
Thank you.
some more barrels on the slope.
Pull the guard fence away! The barrels will roll towards those invading Aztec scum!
Look, leader, we can set these bales of hay on fire and roll them down to deal with the platoons down there.
Pick up the flaming stick and hold it over the hay bales.
Good conscience was telling us to do something evil.
Can here, leader. We have lots of followers, and we've escaped from the Aztecs.
Now, we gotta get ourselves powerful and take the fight back to the Aztec scum. But first, we'll have to conquer the Norse.
Or free them to join us, of course. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. To the Norse land!
Alright, this next land, I'm just gonna skip and go right into the game. Because it's mainly just tutorials. And I'm assuming you guys know how to play enough to skip the tutorials. But if you don't really know how to play, go ahead and stick to this land because it does teach you a few good things to know. But I will also be explaining some of my strategies so you can understand a little bit better way to play. If you want to play good instead of evil.
Look, here are the people we saved. They're exiting the portal. Wonderful.
Yeah, these guys made it, but think of how many got toasted. Anyway, where are we?
This looks like an old Greek settlement. We can reestablish ourselves here. It looks so peaceful here. With no Aztecs, it's the perfect place to build up and get more followers. There is already a town center, a storehouse, and a field which we can use. The green ring you see is the extent of your influence. You can only do things within this ring.
You can extend the green influence ring by placing more buildings and having more people.
When you're ready to learn how to feed your people, click on the gold scroll over the field, leader.
Okay, since I have all the patches installed, which is like one or two patches maybe, if you just press escape, you can skip the land, and get right on to the next one.